The next topic is cholecalciferol or calcifediol. Which one is better and in what way? Well, as we know, in Spain there are a number of vitamin D supplements available, part of the D hormonal system. Among them, we have cholecalciferol, or vitamin D3, which we either obtain from food or from the skin through exposure to sunlight. Then we have calcifediol, or 25-hydroxyvitamin D, which is produced through the first hydroxylation in the liver. It's important to note that calcifediol has a half-life of around 2 to 3 months, and that's why it's the marker we use in biochemical tests to assess the level of 25-OHD. And then we have calcitriol, which is the active hormone produced after the second hydroxylation in the kidneys. Well, the SEM recommends using both cholecalciferol and calcifediol as supplements for the vitamin D hormonal system. Calcitriol is considered, it should not be used as a supplement except in certain cases. For example, patients with kidney failure or hypoparathyroidism. It is not recommended due to the risk of hypercalcemia associated with calcitriol. This table shows the recommendations or the doses that should be used, according to the etiology of the vitamin D deficiency and its severity. Above all, let's focus on this section here, which refers to patients with osteoporosis who may have a severe vitamin D deficiency or a vitamin D insufficiency. So, which one would be better? Well, although it has its disadvantages and can also carry a potential risk of toxicity, in general, calcifediol is considered better because it is 3 to 6 times more effective than cholecalciferol, meaning lower doses are needed. Calcifediol, in comparison, has a shorter half-life and would produce a faster increase in terms of dosage than cholecalciferol, and it would also act more quickly. Likewise, it has been observed that calcifediol has a higher absorption rate compared to cholecalciferol, as well as with intermittent intake of calcifediol. It can result in a more stable and consistent serum 25-hydroxyvitamin D level than if cholecalciferol is used with intermittent intake, such as weekly or monthly.